Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, where we are going to interact and learn together. We are going to have our biology form 3 lesson 14, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on ecology under the subtopic the energy flow in an ecosystem. But before that, we can look at the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to form several food chains and also food webs. Welcome. Let us now get deep into the energy flow in an ecosystem, whereby we can say the sun is the natural source of energy. It is this energy that is trapped by the green plants for photosynthesis. This process produces food, which is potential energy in chemical form, e.g. We can have the glucose. Therefore, green plants are known as producers in an ecosystem. Green plants are eaten by animals. You can have a diagrammatic representation of the same, whereby you'll be observing the diagram. We have said that the green plants eaten by animals, for example, the herbivores. Herbivores are usually referred to as primary consumers, as you can see from our diagram. They in turn are eaten by carnivores, usually referred to as secondary consumers. In our case, our secondary consumer here is the eagle. The secondary consumer is eaten by a tertiary consumer, whereby the tertiary consumer and the tertiary consumers are also can also be decomposed. When the tertiary consumers die, they are eaten by vultures, whereby the vultures, we can call them the quaternary consumers. These feeding levels, that is the producers and the consumer levels, are referred to as trophic levels. When living organisms die, they are decomposed by bacteria and fungi, which are referred to as decomposers, as you can see from our diagram. The energy moves from one trophic level to the next, e.g. From producers to the primary consumers. This passage of energy from one trophic level to the next results in loss of energy in form of heat. As you can see, the loss of energy in form of heat is being represented by the arrows, that is the yellow arrows. During respiration, excretion, or defecation, some energy is also lost. When organic materials are fully decomposed, all the energy is lost from the ecosystem. Thus, energy flows through an ecosystem and it is not recycled. I would like us we do something on the decomposers, because these ones, they are the ones which decompose dead bodies. Dead bodies of organisms and waste materials from bodies of living organisms form a source of energy and nutrients from many other organisms known as decomposers. Most decomposers are bacteria and also fungi. The decomposers break down organic materials into simple substances which are made available for reuse by other organisms. Thus, the materials are recycled in the ecosystem. The rate at which decomposers work on substrate differs depending on climate and also type of substrate. For example, a dead animal takes a matter of weeks, whereas a fallen tree and branches may take many years to decompose. Having done and said that, we can go down to food chains. Remember that we started from producer up to the decomposers. That is why I wanted to touch something on the decomposers. So we can now go back again to food chains. The flow of energy from a producer to another organism is represented linearly as a food chain. A food chain is composed of producers, consumers, and decomposers. For example, green plants are eaten by a herbivore, and the herbivore is eaten by a carnivore. When these organisms die, they are broken down by decomposers. So we have said that the food chain follows from the producer, the primary consumer, and the secondary consumer, and thus. And as you can see from our screen, the first food chain here, we can see the corn is eaten by the rat, and the rat is eaten by the owl. So we can say that the corn can represent the primary consumer, whereby the rat is representing the secondary consumer, and the owl is representing our, the rat is our primary consumer, and the owl will be our secondary consumer. We have our second diagrammatic representation, whereby the carrots are the producers. We have the rabbit as the primary consumer, the fox as the secondary consumer, and the lion as the tertiary consumer. We have also our third representation there, whereby we have the grass, the grasshopper, the frog, the python, and also the Ego. So all these ones are representing food chains. From food chains, we can move further to food webs. In the food webs, we can see that on the food webs, we can see that in a community where populations live and interact, simple food chains rarely exist. Most associations concerned with energy flow are made of several interconnected food chains forming food webs. So the several food chains are the ones which are forming a food web. An example of a food web is the one that we are seeing from our screen, whereby we can have an example of a food chain that is from the corn, whereby the corn is eaten by a grasshopper, So the grasshopper here is the primary consumer, the frog being the secondary consumer, and the python being the secondary, that is the tertiary consumer. We can form so many food chains from this food web. For example, we can have another one whereby we are starting from the flowering plant. Remember, we have said that the plants actually are the producers. So we can have the producer as the flowering plant, the butterfly as the primary consumer, the dragonfly as the secondary consumer, and the thrush as the tertiary consumer. So all these food webs, these are just one food web, but it is being presented by many food chains. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you'll be required to differentiate between the food chain and a food web. For this lesson, you can refer from KLB, Secondary Biology Students Book 3, which is the 4th edition Nairobi, and that has been certified by the Kenya Literature Bureau. And to get for this and many more, you can contact us on by sending us an SMS on the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _ Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels so that we might enjoy more of our biology lessons. Thank you.